And today, we are looking for snow! Oh, so I am excited for this one because it's a little bit messy and you guys know how much I like to get messy. So let's go over our supplies. So if y'all are sitting down with me, you can go grab your supplies and come back. I am using a plastic bin today, but any kind of box would do. So you can take shoes out of a shoe box and just use a shoe box. It's probably the easiest option. Since it is messy, we always like to put the messy thing on a tray, or today I have more of those plastic bags that I used for a previous program. So the idea is, and I'll show you in a second, when we get messy, if it goes over the sides of our box, we've got something to catch it when it falls. Then you're going to need a pair of scissors. You're going to need some tape. And then just a couple of different things. I'm actually using snow. So excited. So I'm not going to make it into real snow. So this is the stuff that we normally use for snow ho-ho here at the library. But since nobody is going to be sticking their hands in anything this year, I thought I would use it for this program. And it comes with a little shovel. I got so excited. So I'm going to be shoveling snow onto my project today.
So cute.
But if you don't have snow, which I don't expect you guys have snow, you can use glitter, you can use soap flakes, like the ivory soap flakes, you can use sand, probably not kinetic sand, but just regular sand, anything that's loose. You can use rice.
Salt.
Salt. Oh, salt would be a good one. Oh, that's so much fun. Still TV. She's always got it. And then we're going to use different things for our roof. So we're making a little house today. So my experiment today, I'm using a paper plate. I'm using a piece of fabric. This is felt. And I'm going to cut and use construction paper. Okay, so you can grab, go and grab some stuff. I'm also, we're going to try one way and then another way. So I need something that I can stand in the middle of my house. This is my house in the middle of my box, and that's a little bit tall. So grab an option for that. Now let's go over our vocabulary before we get into the STEAM activity. So this week we're going to talk about density, and if something is dense, that is how tightly the matter of an object is packed. So if you pick up a handful of snow, it's not very dense, right? It's loose and it just falls out of your gloves. But when you're making a snowball and you take it and you pack it, your snowball has more density to it, all right? Because all of that snow is packed in. All right, matter is anything that has weight or takes up space. So remember, you matter. All right, and sloped is a surface that has one end or side that is at a higher level than the other. So remember, we were talking about this. So this is flat, and this is sloped, okay? So we're going to be talking about snow. We live in Texas. It doesn't really snow. It ices, at least where we are. It snows in some of the other parts of Texas. We don't always get a lot of snow. But in other parts of the country, thinking about this when you're building a house is a very important thing because they get a lot of snow. So we're going to do an experiment today. We're going to experiment with something being flat versus something being sloped and what would make the best roof for our house, okay? So I am going to lay down my, because y'all know last week I made a mess. I made a big old mess when we were making slime. So I'm gonna try and not make as big of a mess this week. I'm going to lay down some of my plastic. So if you've got like a dry cleaning bag, you can lay down some dry cleaning bags. You can do this in the sink depending on what you're pouring. You can do this in the bathtub, again, depending on what you're pouring. Lay down some kind of something, all right? So here's my workspace. And then I'm going to make my first roof. Now the first time we do this experiment, it's going to be flat, all right? So I'm going to take my paper plate and I'm gonna take some of my snow. And the experiment calls for about half a cup. So this is about a cup. I was joking about the little thing. Although that would be adorable, we would be here forever. So I am going to actually flip my plate over. And going to sprinkle some snow onto my roof. Oh, what's happening to my plate? Oh no! Would that be a good roof to have on a house? Goodness, I would not want to be the person inside that house.
Me neither.
The beginning of a Stephen King novel. So we're going to take it and we're going to pour it. I'm going to pour it back. If you've got tons of salt, you just keep going for it. But I've only got one cup of snow. So my paper plate, not so good. I'm going to toss it to the side. Now I'm going to take my felt. And this is going to take some taping because my felt doesn't want to stay up on its own. So I am going to cut a piece of tape and tape down on either, on either side. So I've got one side of my green. Actually, it looks a lot like salt, Miss Josie.
Yeah.
Okay. So my roof is not going to come all the way down because it is taped. But if I was on the second story of my house, that doesn't actually work out too good for us. It's sinking, right? So the more snow the winter has, it's just going to get sinking lower and lower and lower. So let's see if Miss Blair cannot make a mess.
Yeah, I don't want to live in a felt house in summertime either because the snow will melt inside.
Oh, yes. Oh, thank you. I'm going to dump my snow back in. Ho, ho, ho. Snow. Woo! Alright, I'm going to take my fabric, move it to the side, and then the last one I'm going to try is paper. Okay, so I'm going to measure my paper. I'm just going to cut a little bit off the end to make it fit my house better. Bing. There we go. Same thing as the fabric. Well, actually, no. This is staying on. This is good. All right. So we've got our paper roof. So let's try again. We're still working flat, not sloped. Whoa! I barely did anything! That's not a good roof either. Oh my goodness. Wow.
Glad we are not in the house.
I was trying to say, yeah, that's like Texas sized snow. The other one was Wisconsin. And that barely lasted. Texas sized snow and this house is done for. Alright, so obviously, paper is a no go. Okay. So we were working with a flat surface, and our other word was sloped. Okay, so I am going to try to make a sloped roof using my cardboard pieces. Just to make sure that they stay, I'm going to tape the top where they're making a peak, a little roof. Cut off some tape. Should be pretty good just for today. All right, I'm going to use my paper for this one. I'm going to fold my paper in half. Well, not a very good half, but a Blair half. And okay, so we've got our sloped roof. Turn my roof this way because I have more spillage on the sides. So what do you think is going to happen? Do we think that the roof is going to cave in the middle? Do we think my snow is just going to go off to the side? Do we think it's going to do both? like just a big old snow explosion, like a blizzard. Let's see. Let's see. So we've got our salt, our snow, our flakes, and we are going to. Something with the paper, it immediately fell. This time, working with a sloped roof, we could do all of it. Right. And I bet you if my slope was a little bit more sloped, what do you think would happen with all my snow? Right? I think my snow would go down to the ground. Okay, so if we don't have any snow that's on top of our house making the roof cave, and it's going straight down, is that a better roof than my flat roof? I think it would be a better roof. But I want to hear what you have to say in the comments. And then this is going to be comedic relief, watching me put all this snow. Because it's not wanting to bend in the middle because I bent it the other way. Oh, there we go. So we want to make sure if we made a mess that we clean up our mess. It is our responsibility as scientists, engineers, that we take responsibility and we clean up after ourselves. All right. So our question this week, or think about it, are there things you can do to these materials, right, our roof, to make them more slippery for the snow to fall off? So in our experiment, we already decided we like sloped, not flat, for a winter roof. So is there anything that you can do to make it slippery? So as soon as the snow hits, it goes off your roof. All right, so that's what I want to see in the comments below. I hope you guys had fun. I hope you made a little bit of a mess, but not too much of a mess. We will be back for one more Maker Monday, and that's it. We've only got one more. It'll be next Monday, 4:30, same place. And it'll the supplies will be posted on Saturday, like they usually are. But I'm gonna go ahead and give you a hint. It's my favorite one. We're gonna be making a mancala board. So I don't know if you've ever played that board game. It's one of my favorites of all time. So we're gonna make a board game, and I'm gonna teach you how to play next week. So I'm definitely looking forward to that. Thank you guys so much.